three different sounds, or two different sounds, in this case three. Hi-hat, snare, kick. You don't want to write something or create something on a really washy sound. It's distracting. So pick something tight sound. That for your right hand, that's really where you want to be. So you can write something that you can focus on sticking, develop the muscle memory. So the second step is memorization. So you want to start with the three sound sources you were using, and then you want to start to move it around a little bit. And that's where you step into the application. So start with the sticking, continue with that sticking, and you'll see where it goes just by moving it around kick.
Special.
Good sound. He was a sound. My style of drumming, I think, is pretty different from his. My sound is different than his. And so he's able to take a groove and make it sound like only he can, I think. So John Bonham's excellence inspires me. How good he is at what he does. But as far as his style, not so much. Yeah. And a lot of that has to do with first question, I'll just read. So when JD writes a riff, my job is to make the song sound really good with my drums, to make everything fit. And the John Bonham grooves work really well for what they were doing, you know, that sound. But for August Burns Red, it's oftentimes very mechanical and tight, you know, it's very tight stops, tight hits. And so I've always worked at that side of the drumming. So as far as August Burns Red coming back here, we have plans to tour a lot next year. And I just talked to JD last night, and I was like, we gotta go back to Southeast Asia. There's a lot of people here that want to see the band. And he's like, I would like that. And I said, me too. So we'll be back. I don't know if it'll happen next year. I know there's talk of going to Australia. And Australia's not the furthest thing away. Yeah, first thing away. We probably make the most sense of our trip by going there and, you know, escrowing the trips together. So, thank you. Good question.
Thank you so much.
Back to the birthday boy.
Hi, Matt. I have a great life, by the way.
What's that?
Can you teach us your 8-1 routine?
8-1?
Yeah.
Yeah. How do you know about that?
I just watch your Instagram videos.
You have Instagram?
Yeah, but can you elaborate on that?
Yeah, definitely.
Thanks.
Thank you, that's a good question. So, I like linear drumming a lot. Linear drumming means there's one hit at a time. So I was working on this idea to go through, to develop an exercise, which I did, called 8-1. But before that, I started with some of you guys like basketball, most of you don't apparently, but N1 is the name of the exercise. Here's what it is. It's all 16 notes on your hands and feet. Your hi-hats keep a quarter of the time. This is so much fun. But it took a long time, so just be patient. It's the first time you've seen this. 16 notes on your hands. On the end, that's on the end, that's on the end. That's the one you need. Yeah, that note's keep a quarter of the time. So, on the end, that's on the end. Now, you're going to substitute a foot for every other 16 notes. So it's going to be one hand, one foot. So it's going to be hand foot, 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 hand foot. Like this. Your left foot is so many quarters of a time. So you have 20 and 50, 50, 50, 50, 50. Count it. Thank you.
81, which is this. Same idea, one hand, one foot, two different toms, so you have different sounds. 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
This one's really hard to play. Thanks for bringing this up.
Alternating.
relaxing notes at the same tempo. I'll show you.